Welcome to the video review of Metal Gear Survive. For the full written review, please click the link in the description. Okay, so it's not going to offer the closure fans wanted following the Phantom Pain's weak attempt at an ending. And no, Hideo Kojima wasn't involved in its production. But despite all the hate Metal Gear Survive is getting, it's actually not a bad little game. Borrowing locations and mechanics from the previous game, but putting its own twist on both, this strange survival spin-off title crucially never feels like a retread of old content. Even familiar settings are able to feel fresh based on the new ways you approach them and new things to see and do. Survive is basically two different games fused together for reasons. The multiplayer side of things takes the form of a wave-based survival mode where the gear and gadgets crafted in solo play help you and your allies fend off hordes of zombie-like nasties. It's dumb, sure, but it's still good fun. Even though enemy approach routes are shown, it's easy to get caught up in a heated battle and miss another pack making moves on your base. While that'd likely be an auto loss in single player, having three extra defenders in online play means someone is likely to spot and deal with the threat. It's chaos in a good way. Meanwhile, Survive's solo campaign takes the form of a much more traditional survival game. Food and fluid intakes need to be managed, better gear and supplies crafted from whatever you can find. It's like a super hardcore version of Snake Eater, basically, but, you know, worse. Layering on a ton of new mechanics over the sublime fundamentals of the Phantom Pain muddies the water somewhat. Everything still works okay, but it only manages to elevate itself to more than that when all its systems are in play at once. The basic grunts are dumb, but that doesn't mean they're not fun to fight. Despite thirst and hunger meters ticking your life away, you can still have plenty of quick and simple stealth fun messing with daft zombies. And it's not like things don't get more interesting when new enemy types are added. Between sorties, you'll need to manage your base camp to make sure supplies are plentiful, fortifications strong, and fellow survivors well looked after. It's a basic system, but it works well enough. Plus, you get to listen to classic Metal Gear and Konami tunes you found on your travels while you go about your busy work. Resource containers and other useful kit like this Walker gear sometimes wash up through the same nonsensical wormholes that brought you into this strange world. They're extremely helpful, so it's always worth hunting them down. The story itself is sort of awful, but at least it facilitates some entertaining gameplay. Just try to ignore the one-note characters and the hilarious attempts to tie this into Metal Gear canon, and the revolting microtransactions. There's a fair bit to ignore, actually. Post-game is where Metal Gear Survive comes closest to shining, if you can make it that far. Powerful new enemies are added, and the loot just keeps getting better. If it can get its hooks in, the loot is pretty solid. Or there's multiplayer to rinse for as long as you like, with boxes of rewards galore for those teams skilled enough to hit the top rankings. With updates coming that'll add new maps and modes, this will be where the game's legs lie, if it ends up having any. Metal Gear Survive isn't the car crash it could have been, and sometimes even verges on being genuinely good. But with so many great games vying for your time, is that enough? Try it for yourself. We score Metal Gear Survive 6 out of 10. If you enjoyed this video, then please click the like button and subscribe for more game reviews like this coming soon. For more news, reviews and articles, visit eddieforums.com, Europe's busiest home entertainment community. Thanks for watching.